Hello students, welcome to e-classes of P.N. Amarsingh High School. We will continue with our chapter number 7, fraction. Exercise 7.1, question number 1. Write the fraction representing the shaded portion. Here we have to write down the fraction which the figure is representing. Here we have to write down the fraction which is representing the shaded portion. So first we will write down the denominator, for which we will find out how many total parts are there. 1, 2, 3 and 4. There are total 4 parts, so in the denominator we will write 4. And the shaded portion are 1 and 2. So in the numerator we will write 2. So the fraction of this figure is 2 by 4. Now figure number 2. Here also first we will find out the total parts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here total 9 parts are there. So in the denominator we will write 9. And the shaded parts are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here in the numerator we will write 8. So the fraction representing the shaded portion is 8 by 9. In the same way in figure 3. Total parts are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here we will write 8 in denominator. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 are shaded. So in the numerator we will write 4. So the fraction form is 4 by 8. Now fourth figure. The total parts are 1, 2, 3 and 4. So in the denominator we will write 4. And the shaded portion is in one part. So in the numerator we will write 1. So the fraction form of this figure is 1 by 4. Students, remaining question number 1 of exercise 7.1 you have to do by yourself. Now question number 2. Color the part according to the given fraction. Here we have to color the figure according to the given fraction. Figure number 1. Here the fraction is 1 by 6. Here total 6 parts are given. We have to color one part. In this way you have to color the figure. Second and third you have to do by yourself. Now fourth one. In the fourth figure the fraction form is 3 by 4. Total 4 parts are there. We have to color on 3 parts. In this way you have to color in figure 4. Fifth one you have to do by yourself. Question number 3. Identify the error if any. Error means mistake. We have to identify if there is any mistake or not. In this figure first, the fraction form is 1 by 2. Here the fraction 1 by 2 means one part out of two equal parts. The figure here you can see, students, that it is divided into two unequal parts. This is smaller and this is bigger part. So the shaded part does not represent the fraction 1 by 2. Now, second figure. This is 1 by 4. Here the mistake is the fraction 1 by 4 means one part out of four equal parts. And the figure has divided into four unequal parts. You can see here, these two parts are equal and these two parts are equal. All the four parts are not of equal measurement. So we can see that the shaded part does not represent the fraction 1 by 4. Now figure number 3, this is 3 by 4. The fraction 3 by 4 means 3 parts out of 4 equal parts. The figure is divided into 4 unequal parts. Here also you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 parts are there where all the parts are not equal. So the 3 shaded parts do not represent the fraction 3 by 4. Question number 4 of exercise 7.1. What fraction of a day is 8 hours? Solution for question number 4. A day has 24 hours. Students, as you all know, one day is equals to 24 hours. So 8 hours is equals to, here in the denominator we will write the total hours, that is 24, and in the numerator we will write 8. So the fraction is 8 by 24. Now in the place of 8, we will write 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 2. 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8. And in the place of 24, we will write 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 3. 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 3's are 24. We will cut this 2 from above the line and this 2 from below the line. This also 2 we will cut from above the line and this 2 from below the line. And this 2 also we will cut from above the line and from below the line. Now here no number is there. So we will write 1 in the numerator and in denominator 3 is remaining. So we will write 3 over here. Therefore 8 hours of a day is 1 by 3. Question number 5. What fraction of an hour is 40 minutes? Now solution for question number 5. An hour has 60 minutes. As you all know, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So 40 minutes is equal to, in the denominator we will write 60 and in the numerator we will write 40. Now 0, 0 we will cut. Now here in the numerator 4 is remaining and in the denominator 6 is remaining. 4 means 2 multiply by 2 and 6 means 2 multiply by 3. 2, 3 is 6. 2 from the above line and 2 from below the line we will cut. Now here in the numerator 2 is remaining and in the denominator 3 is remaining. So 40 minutes is 2 by 3 of an hour. Students, with this we end our today's video and will continue with our chapter in the next video. Thank you.